Yeah, why should Kenyans be happy about your budget?
Thank you. Yeah, first, I think you it's very clear that we continue to pursue an economic plan that continues to ensure that the economy expands, and that's why we've put significant resources to ensure that we continue to expand our economy, at the same time addressing the challenges that we have. You know clearly that over the last 1 year or so, we've been hit by, you know, challenges of insecurity, drought, and all and the like. And these are things that we need to quickly address to make sure that we continue the pace of economic growth so that we can create the jobs that we need, reduce poverty and inequality, that the big issues that we face in this economy. So the budget is implementing the economic strategy or agenda that we have put in place to ensure that we take this economy to a higher level and address our bigger issues.
I mean, some of those who look at the budget, you know, just say this was largely targeted at industrialists, at the macro, at investors. Would you agree with that?
Well, it's a combination of both. First, I think we needed to face the big challenge of stagnating in our manufacturing sector. And this is where jobs are created. We need to address why our manufacturing sector has not expanded over the last decade or so. Its contribution to GDP has just been in the range of 8-10%. Export has stagnated, and we needed to do something. So a lot of measures that we've put in place is to jumpstart, so to speak, our manufacturing sector, because this is where the jobs are. And this is what we are seeing missing at the moment. The job creation is not fast enough to absorb the labor entrance into the system, and that's why we need this sector to get on moving as quickly as possible. So a lot of measures was to address this. We of course know that agriculture is also still important, but we also had put significant resources there while addressing the challenges that we have. So it's a combination of dealing with the sectors that needs to absorb the labor, and because having our youth getting the job, we address the real challenges affecting our economy.
But you know, the common man on the street looks at what is it for me, and perhaps it may be, you know, limited in terms of their understanding of how, you know, the budget actually affects them. But if you were to tell people watching at home what they can expect to change in their favor in the next 12 months, what would you highlight?
Well, first is that the expenditure measures that are in place, if you look at the strategy that we are pursuing, is grow the economy and also make sure that we are ensuring that we are spending on human capital development. If you look at what we have done on increasing capitation for education, we want to make education truly free. And to make it truly free, we need to increase spending so that the parents and students reduce the out-of-pocket spending for both education and health. You might not see it you know, quickly like that, but what parents are spending on education now is huge. But if we put more resources to ensure that the education is free, you save out-of-pocket spending for education, and also health, if you see the resources we have put. And in addition, we have expanded the resources that goes to the social protection or the cash transfers to the vulnerable, to the society, looking at to the elderly, to the orphans, to the, you know, many those who are already benefiting from this. These are resources that are helped to cushion them from the current challenges as we move quickly to expand the economy and then get into absorbed into the market.
All right. Okay, let's move to the roads maintenance levy. And immediately you mentioned that there's a bit of ooh because of the high transport costs that Kenyans already, you know, facing. Is it the poison chalice? Why did you choose to touch on that?
Really, if you look at the road maintenance levy, the last time it was revised was almost 8 years ago. It has been over time eroded by, you know, inflation. The cost of maintaining roads have increased significantly over the last 8 years. What we used to spend 8 years ago and now is completely different. So there was need to revise the, I mean, to update this, and that's why we went into, you know, increasing the levy from just 9 to 12 shillings. It's just 3 shillings. In fact, it doesn't really match the what has happened over the last 8 years in terms of really inflation.
But what are you looking at?
With nine shillings per liter, we collect around 27 billion. Mm-hmm. So 3 shillings, we're looking at collecting probably about 9 billion shillings. Mm-hmm. This will go into, obviously, we are going to pay this to the annuity fund that we have just created, and will go into building, you know, the roads both in urban and also to the rural areas. And will this again will play a big role, mm-hmm, in terms of, you know, supporting economic activity, market access, and all that. So it's important that first we were correcting the over years this levy has been eroded by inflation, mm-hmm, and there is need for us to now secure a funding for our new approach of doing roads, which are more efficient and delivers the service much faster than the old method.
And you expect that to be implemented immediately?
We are actually on the first phase of the 10,000 kilometer roads under the annuity. Mm. The 3,000 kilometers have already been finalized in terms of evaluation. We expect this to be awarded very soon, and we think by the beginning of the next financial, which is next month, we should see a few roads under the annuity kickoff. So we'll be funding the annuity fund through allocations that we are putting in the budget, mm, together with this fund that is coming from the 3 shillings that we've raised.
Let's move to the famous, or is it infamous, syntax. And you chose to do it differently this time, you know, based on the quantity as opposed to the price. Why is that, and what are you hoping to achieve?
Well, ideally, that is really the best way to design an excise tax is based on, you know, quantities, not usually the value. Because looking at, as you say, this is a syntax. You're trying to control the costs that is associated by the consumption or the production of these products, which it ranges from cigarettes, beer, gasolines, which pollute the air and all that. So generally, the principle behind an excise tax is just to tax because it causes costs to others. And this time round, we've focused on the quantity, mm, and then have what we are saying every year will be adjusting the cost here to make sure that again is not eroded by inflation over time. Mm-hmm. So it's a best practice to go specifics in this tax, which is rather than ad valorem, and we believe that we in the design we will get some revenue out of it, and again control some of the externalities, environment, mm-hmm, diseases that is brought about by tobacco and of course beer.
All right, let's move on to the sugar industry. And it has many woes. And the first analysis of the measure in terms of raising, you know, the duty on the imports, yeah, was that isn't quite what really, you know, ails the sugar sector, that there's a lot of politicking around it, that perhaps there are many other incentives that need to be brought in terms of governance that would really make a real difference. So what are your thoughts on that?
You're right. I mean, we are addressing both. Mm. As you see, what we're doing on Mumias, where we have a big challenge in governance, we are fixing that. A lot of things are happening in Mumias now as we speak, in terms of you know, the structuring that has happened in the management, in the governance structure. We are now in the process of preparing a rights issue. They have already developed a very solid plan to turn around the sector. We know that Mumias, mm-hmm, has huge potential, mm-hmm, and that is why we are saying that as we fix the governance issues, the domestic challenges that they have had, we also can support it by ensuring that we are protecting it also from already what we call sort of a dumping from abroad. There's very cheap sugar coming from outside there. We think that it's sort of unfair to our farmers here, and that's why we've increased the levy for that, and we fix our sugar. Recently we also passed Parliament passed give us a go ahead to restructure the five companies that that are now, you know, under privatization. So all these we are doing that for the to sort of resuscitate, and we think we have what it takes to turn around our sugar sector.
But in the short term, increasing prices at the till.
Well, it may come with that for now, but we believe that Mumias, for example, can turn around very quickly. It should also be able to fill the requirements domestically, and it has huge potential as so long as we fix the governance issues that you've just said and other things that we are working on at the moment.
All right, CS, I'll allow you to give us your final thoughts, including on a scale of 1 to 10, how exhausted are you?
Very.
Okay, that's a 15, right, okay. Your final thoughts on the budget and what you're hoping to achieve, and suppose if you could also touch on the fact that really at the end of the day, it's about absorption of these funds.
Correct.
And the fact that there doesn't appear to be, you know, a specific strategy to say that we're going to look at every ministry to get as close to 100% absorption of this so that it actually makes the impact.
Yeah, we, as we speak now, we have already, you know, told ministries, departments to prepare as quickly as possible to start, you know, if it is procurement processes, they should have start planning now. So we need to see the procurement plans in place before the July 1. We need to see the cash plans that are required. So planning is very important to absorb this money. I fully agree that there have been challenges of absorption, but it is really, if you start your planning very well, plan your procurement in a way, and we are already reviewing the procurement law. We hope it should be passed before the end of this month. Should simplify it and make it easier for people to absorb money. I think if we absorb the resources that we have set for the next financial year, we are set to, you know, move the economy to higher growth level and deal with some of the many challenges that we see now.
All right. Well, we wish you well. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
For braving the evening as well.
Thank you.
Joining us in studio, Treasury Cabinet Secretary Henry Rotich. We're taking a short break. We're back with more news and, of course, Opinion Court after these messages. Don't go away.
Asante.